morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Welcome to the Unitarian Universalist Congregation of Fort Myers, both in person and on Zoom. If you are looking for a congregation that encourages a commitment to your personal faith and seeking a place that will accommodate you and your family in a space of diversity and inclusion, then look no further. We are also in the process of renewing our Welcoming Congregation certification. The Welcoming Congregation program is a volunteer program for congregations that want to take intentional steps to be more welcoming and inclusive of people of all sexual orientations and gender identities. We want to create a safe space for everyone to be their authentic self. Be you. Love whoever you want to love. Be cis or transgender. Be gay, straight, bi, queer, questioning, intersex, asexual, and other sexual identities, including pansexual and two-spirit. We love all of you. Our mission is to love, grow, and serve. My name is Jennifer Grant, and I am your worship associate this morning. As president-elect of our congregation, I have pledged to be transparent with our congregation. This will be my fourth time preaching about my time serving on the board. I first spoke to you about a year ago about saying yes to becoming the president-elect of UUCFM. I shared with you my lessons learned after attending my first board retreat. I also participated in a service with the members of the Respectful Relations team. And today, I share the pulpit with the members of the Futures team. Can I have the members of the Futures team, if you're here, kind of go, woo,
you're here.
So recognizing the members of the Future team. And Patricia, Vivier-Naidl, I hope I pronounced it correctly, close enough. And Diane Bothfeld is also joining me, as well as our fabulous music director, John Dalton, our small but mighty choir. And as always, I want to extend gratitude for our fabulous tech team who makes all of this possible. There is a lot of behind the scenes work that you cannot see to create a blended live and Zoom service. It is good to be with all of you today. I want to envision a future where we all share our talents. Today's service will be a celebration of survival, a time to be real with each other, and a time to focus on the future. Do we have any guests or visitors with us today? Warm welcome to our guests and our visitors. And we invite you to complete a connection card, which I think most of you have done so. Hopefully you picked one up on your way into the sanctuary. And if you're joining us virtually, please find the connection card in our chat box. And the most important gift you can give us today, for those of you who are visitors, is a chance to get to know you. Members may also use this card for a change in contact information or a caring concern you want our pastoral care associates to address. For those of you joining us on Zoom, we ask that you please keep your microphone muted and refrain from sending chat messages until asked to do so. And now, let us begin our service. So my call to worship this morning is Come In, Be Among Us by Shari Woodbury. And this is a shared call to worship. So when I lift my arms up, this section of the sanctuary will say the blue font, and you will say, come in. Let's try this.
Come in.
Beautiful. The other side of the sanctuary, when you see the green font, you will say, be among us.
Be among us.
I think you've got this. You ready to roll? Let's do this. To all of you yearning for community.
Come in. Be among us.
To all of you just getting started, to all who long to go deeper, to all with tender places needing care.
Come in. Be among us.
And you all can join in too. To the ones who have healed and have care to give, for those who are curious and hungry to learn, for those who know that they have something to teach.
Come in, be among us.
For the ones who are just beginning to suspect they might nurture others becoming, to the youth and to the old, the innocent and the jaded, the fresh of mind and the deeply steeped, there is room here for each and every one.
Come in, be among us.
That was beautiful. Thank you so much. My words for the chalice lighting come from Pat Uribe-Lichty. Please rise in body or spirit. The chalice we light today is a symbol of our faith. It binds us together as one people, a reminder that our strength is in our shared hope for the world, and that our common work is the creation of beloved community among ourselves and in the world. Please join me in stating the words to our covenant.
Love is the spirit of his congregation, and service is law. This is our great covenant, to dwell together in peace, to seek the truth in love, and to help one another.
We will now sing our opening hymn, number 168, One More Move. The title of this hymn is actually One More Step, but to be more inclusive, we will sing One More Move, whether you walk or roll. Let's take one more move. The words are on the screen above, and the music is in the gray hymnal. Hymn number 168. And Diane, who are you representing?
I am somebody.
So we can call her somebody. So maintaining and revitalizing our church and our congregation involves numerous actions and talents, some large, some small, but all are important. This past year, we asked somebody to call members to check in and offer support when needed.
Hello, hello, oh, good to talk to you today. You know, we got you a ride. Ted will be over this morning to be able to take you to that appointment. Will that be okay? Oh, great, hope you're well, bye now.
To purchase band books. To be president-elect. To bake for the monthly Sunday potluck and make blueberry pies and muffins. Oh, you have one more thing. You have one more thing. You have one more thing. theater, welcoming new and familiar folks on Sunday mornings.
Good morning. I'm so glad you're here. Here's an order of service. Thank you very much. Have a great day.
To paint the restrooms. To write about events and community happenings for the weekly newsletter and the monthly communicator. To usher Sunday services. To make and answer phone calls. To trim the hedges, weed, rake, or water the garden. To facilitate connection circles, sing in the choir, or speak at a worship service, organize an event like an auction. It looks like somebody is going to need some help. Our church calls us to bring all that you are. This includes our talents, known and yet to be discovered, to light our way forward into the upcoming year. We are asking.
Good morning, beloved community.
Good morning.
It was the third Sunday of October, 2008. I had been widowed just over a year, and I felt it was time to find a spiritual community and get back into life. And so on that day, I walked towards this building by myself, and I opened the door on that side to the narthex, and I came in. Immediately, two women came right over to me to welcome me, and welcome me warmly. It was Judy Burgett, and it was Barbara Boynton. They've always been friends of mine ever since. You know, I don't remember a single thing they said, but I will never, ever forget how they made me feel. They made me feel so welcome that soon I felt included. And then I felt really engaged. And 4 weeks later, I joined the community. And I added my time, my talent, and my treasure to this beloved community. And I was so glad that I had found a home. That was 16 years ago. It's hard to believe. But over those 16 years, I realized more and more that the task of welcoming new people is not just the task of the welcoming committee. It's my task. It's your task. It's each and every one of us that has this task. It's also an opportunity to help our congregation grow and grow into the future. You know, it's really not easy to walk up to someone you've never seen before and start a conversation. If you're an introvert, it's even harder. But there are certain ways of doing it and certain things that we can do that would help people feel welcome. You introduce yourself, ask their name, ask where they're from. Ask them if this is their first time at a UU service. If they say, oh no, we belong to the UU church in some other state, then you know you already have common ground. If they say, this is my very first time here, like I did, then you know that you really want to concentrate on them. Ask them how they felt about the service. Use the word feel, and use the word welcome. Also, tell them how you feel about being a UU, why you are here, and how much you love this community. That means a lot to a newcomer. It makes them feel more at home, more equal. Tell them that you look forward to seeing them again, and keep their name and their vision, their face in your mind. You know, when all that's said and done, yeah, they may not remember a single thing that you said to them, but they will never, ever forget how you made them feel welcome.
In-betweenness by Michelle LaGrave. We, you and I, are in between right now. In between what was and what will be. In between who we were and who we will become. In between letting go and embracing. In between saying hello and saying goodbye. In-betweenness, it's a thing. In-betweenness is a time of fullness, a time of anticipation, a time of hope, a time of worry, a time of sadness. In-betweenness is a time of waiting. Waiting for news, waiting for departure, waiting for arrival, waiting for death, waiting for life. In-betweenness is a time of transformation, a time of reflection, a time of action, a time of growing, a time of becoming. During this time of in-betweenness, of knowing and not knowing, let us enter into the silence together. Amen, and blessed be. If you have a stone with you this morning, I invite you to hold that stone in your hand close to your heart. During the music meditation, come forward to place your stone in the bowls of sand with others in this extended, beloved, welcoming community. Allow your stone to symbolize your intentions, your reflections, prayers, joys, sorrows, or milestones in your life. For those of you who are on Zoom, If you would like your joys and sorrows to be shared with our caring team, please share in the chat. You may also click the green button on this page to place your stone of intention this morning. I will place the first three stones this morning. The first stone will be a stone of peace for the innocent victims of war in Ukraine, Israel, Palestine, and the Gaza Strip. The second stone will be for the UUC-FM community. We are a community of resilience and survival. The third stone represents our future at UUC-FM. What will we become? Now I will place a final stone for all that remains in our hearts. May our prayers be heard and our hearts restored. During the past 5 years, our congregation has been through a global pandemic, a failed interim minister, and almost a Cat 5 hurricane. So let's talk about the global pandemic. Did you know that prior to COVID, there were 1,000 Unitarian Universalist congregations across the country? Once the pandemic hit in March 2020, all Unitarian Universalist congregations were meeting via Zoom or some other platform, including UUC of M. We found a way to make Zoom services work. We have a superb tech team who, by trial and error, figured out how to stream our services. Since we live in Florida, our congregation began meeting back in person beginning in November of 2021. Remember, prior to COVID, there were how many congregations? One, good, you were listening, yay. 1,000 Unitarian Universalist congregations across the US. Post-COVID, there are now only 800 Unitarian Universalist congregations in the United States. For those of you who know me, math is not my strong point. However, doing simple math, the Unitarian Universalist faith lost 200 congregations since 2020. 200, and yet we survived. Please rise in body or spirit or hand gestures so we can recognize and celebrate you here in the sanctuary. Or if you are on Zoom, turn on your cameras and raise your hand if you were a member of the worship team, a member of the tech team, a member of the choir, played music during the service, served as an usher or greeter from 2020 until the present, or if you attended a service during this time. Celebrate you and your service and dedication to this congregation. We survive because of you. In addition to the global pandemic, our congregation thrived while we struggled to find a settled minister. I want to celebrate the resiliency of our congregation. In June of 2019, our minister of 10 years resigned. Any time a minister resigns is a challenging time for a congregation. We had a failed interim ministry in 2019, followed by a short-term, part-term minister who only served 3 months in 2020. Her ministry was cut short due to the pandemic. Our congregation was without a minister for several years, and we survived. We have had a fabulous board of trustees during that time, and currently, pastoral care associates, an amazing group of worship associates, and two paid lay-led ministers. Please rise in body or spirit so we can recognize and celebrate you here in the sanctuary. And if you are on Zoom, turn your cameras on and raise your hand. If during March of 2020 until the present, to the present, you served as a pastoral care associate, a worship associate, served on the board of trustees, sang in the choir, played music during the service, or served as an usher or greeter from 2020 until the present, or attended a service. Stand up, make yourself known. Already, oh. We celebrate you and your service and dedicated to this congregation. We survived because of you. In addition to the global pandemic and our struggle to find a minister, we also survived Ian, almost a Cat 5 hurricane. I want to celebrate the resiliency of our congregation. Every time Southwest Florida gets hit by a hurricane, people leave. We had several members who left after Irma and more left after Ian. Some of our members either lost their home or their cars or had major damage to their homes. Our church also suffered from the wrath of Ian. If you suffered from damage from Ian, or you help neighbors, friends, or UUCFM community, or the larger community, I want to recognize you. Please rise in body or spirit in the sanctuary, or if you are on Zoom, turn the cameras back on and raise your hand so we can recognize and celebrate your resiliency. We celebrate you and your resiliency to your home, our beautiful shared welcoming space we call our spiritual home, as well as the broader Southwest Florida community. We survived because of you. I am so proud of this congregation and our survival during the past 5 years. We survived because of you. We are part of the 800 congregations across the country who survived during this time. So now, let's be real. During my upcoming presidency, I want to continue practicing what I learned from the Respectful Relations training. I want to be a transparent leader. I want all of us to understand our challenges as a congregation and to envision a future where our dreams of what we can become materialize in our congregation. I want to be transparent, direct, and honest with you. I want to continue practicing respectful relations during board meeting, congregational meetings, and conversations. I have been so impressed at how Bill Petrarca has led board meetings, and I hope that board meetings will continue to be respectful, productive, joyful, and fun. While I may have the title of President of Board of Trustees as of April 1st, 2024, I want to share this leadership with all of you. I want us to say yes together as we envision our future. I see a future where we can all be honest, direct, and respectful towards each other. So let's start with the reality of our finances. Our operating budget appears to be considerably deeper in deficit than we projected. As reported in the Shire Crier, how many of you read the Shire Crier? Our financial challenges can be summarized as follows. The trend lines for revenues to cover annual operating expenses are not sustainable in the long run. We will run out of funds within the next 5 to 6 years. Let's let that sink in. We will run out of funds within the next 5 to 6 years. But look at what we have achieved since 2020, and I realized, math, that's only been 4 years. I'm not good at math. So it's been the last 4 years that we have survived while 200 other Unitarian Universalist congregations closed their doors. We freaking survived the global pandemic, and during that same time, survived an almost Cat 5 hurricane, and survived without a minister for 3 years. We got this. So let's focus on our future. Let's chat about our amazing minister we have had for almost 2 years. Reverend Sue is making a difference in our congregation and the community. During her first year, she served as a part-time minister, and in her second year, which she started in August, she is serving as a three-fourth or three-quarter time minister. And by the end of April, she and her husband, Ulysses, will be moving from Costa Rica to Southwest Florida. Woo! So instead of having 2 in-person services and 1 Zoom service with Reverend Sue each month, we will have 3 in-person services with Reverend Sue each month. Her sermons are thought-provoking and pull at your heartstrings. I love her creativity. How fun was the service where we got to pick and unopen a gift during the holiday service, and inside each gift was an element of the worship service. I will never forget the service where we put blankets over fellow worship associate Leslie Gatto to symbolize the oppression of African American people. It was so powerful. Not only Reverend Sue's words, but the visual representation. I wasn't able to be here in person, but I watched on Zoom from my hotel room in Santa Barbara, California. It has been an honor and a privilege working with her as a worship associate and a board member. I want you to all realize the value that Reverend Sue brings with her years of experience as a UU minister and as a leader. And in addition to our congregations shrinking in numbers, do you know that the UU minister pool is also shrinking? A recent communication from the UUA has announced a dire shortage of ministers willing to serve congregations. While there are ministers available, few are willing to accept the positions. The UUA Transitions Director widely circulated letter from June 23, 2023 indicates the gravity of the situation. In this letter, it states, for years, the transition office would hear from about 25 to 30 newly fellowship ministers looking to consider congregational ministry. The last 2 years, it's been 5 ministers, then 8. The Venice congregation here in Southwest Florida is currently in the search process for a minister, and our sister church in Fort Myers is led by a lay-led minister. We are so blessed to have Reverend Sue as our minister. We also hired an amazing director of music. John, you are freaking amazing. I was counting just to make sure my math was right. You have taken a choir of just 6 voices and have been able to blend and harmonize their voices. Thank you to our small but yet mighty choir. We also have a beautiful campus. Our fixed assets are worth well over $5 million. Our main strategic objective is to reconfigure our fixed assets, the buildings and the grounds, to generate annual income to help defray operating expenses. Some ancillary strategies, such as membership growth, will relieve budgetary pressures. The board has charged the futures team, along with several board members, with assessing sustainability opportunities for UUCFM. We have asked them to take several months to understand the nature of our mission and vision, to identify and evaluate different strategies to ensure the long-term sustainability of our congregation and mission, to reach out to the congregation and our community stakeholders to incorporate their concerns, ideas, and expectations, to make recommendations to the Board of Trustees, who in turn will present strategies for congregational concurrence and approval. Our optimum strategies will be four of them. 1, be mission-driven and consistent with our UU values. 2, promote spiritual excitement, fostering congregational engagement. 3, stimulate membership growth. And 4, secure long-term sustainability for our congregation and our mission. In keeping with our fiduciary obligations to the congregation, the board will seek support and directions from several outside subject matter experts, such as the UUA, other congregations, and independent consultants to work with the futures team and our congregation. The board has agreed to engage Partners for Sacred Places to assist us in the sustainability journey. Breaking news, the contract with Partners for Sacred Places was just signed yesterday, March 2nd.
Yay!
For over 30 years, Partners for Sacred Places has established a reputation for developing new tools and programs that assist congregations in making the most of their properties as assets for ministry. Their resources focus on helping a congregation live out its mission by sharing its space, collaborating with its community, and serving its neighbors in new and powerful ways. You can expect to be asked to become involved with the strategic visioning and community conversations with our stakeholders. I am excited about building connections with our community partners. I would love to see us work more closely with the MAC. Last year, and that's the music. What does MAC stand for? Help me out.
Music and Arts Community
Center. Thank you. Last year, we had our first joint fundraiser. We raised a total of $10,000. $5,000 went to the Gulf Coast Symphony Orchestra, and UUC also received $5,000. The Gulf Coast Symphony also held a UU special matinee for Snowbird Follies. For those of you who are interested in the environment, I would love to see you get connected with RESET. The Southwest Florida RESET Center is a physical place right here on our campus with facilities and capabilities to share resources, set common goals, and augment outreach on environmental and related issues on regional importance. It will help to answer the urgent need to bring diverse organizations together for maximal impact within and beyond our region. The mission of the Southwest Florida RESET Center is to serve as a consensus-building hub, inspiring collaborative local and regional actions throughout transformative education to reset human impacts on the natural world. And some of you may not know this, in the summer of 2024, the Quakers will be breaking ground on their new spiritual home, which will be on our property. Quakers, yes. Thank you for starting that. Quakers, if you don't know, are people who belong to the Religious Society of Friends, a historically Protestant Christian set of denominations. Members of these movements, the Friends, are generally united by a belief in each human's ability to experience the light within or answering that of God in everyone. Their beliefs align very closely to our UU principles. I love the idea of working with the Quakers on social justice opportunities. Speaking about community partnerships, I would love to see UUCFN members volunteer at one of our community partnerships, whether it's volunteering at the Q, the Quality Life Center, or getting involved with Visuality, the Alliance for Fair Food, the Center for Independent Living, and Life. Speaking about life, get your calendars ready. Get them out. So if you use your phone for your calendar, if you have a paper calendar, get your calendars out. I would love to see everyone in this room attend the Life Rally on Tuesday, March 12th at the Gateway Trinity Lutheran Church at 6:15. Time right? Gathering at 6:15. I will repeat that. It's the Life Rally on Tuesday, March 12th at the Gateway Trinity Lutheran Church, which that's near me, woo-woo, at 6:15 p.m. And I would also encourage every member and friend of this congregation to attend the Life Nehemiah Action Committee. That is on Tuesday, April 9th, also at 6:15, at Fort Myers High School on Cortez Boulevard. I will repeat that. The Life Nehemiah Action Committee meeting is Tuesday, April 9th, also at 6:15, at the Fort Myers High School on Cortez Boulevard. This is an exciting time for all of us as a congregation, as we live out the very nature of our evolutionary faith by defining new opportunities to transform ourselves in service to others. Inspired by the covenantal love of faith community, success of this initiative is defined as a new viable UUCFM with, are you ready for this? A full-time minister. A DRE with a strong faith exploration program for adults and youth. A vibrant social justice team. And continuing inspirational worship ministry. with your support, our leaders' diligence, and our community stakeholders' support, I am confident we can make this happen over the next few years. In 1961, during his inauguration speech, President John F. Kennedy stated, Ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country. He challenged every American to contribute in some way to the public good. 63 years later, if my math is correct, 63 years later, I want to challenge every member and friend of this congregation. Ask not what UUCFM can do for you. Ask what you can do for UUCFM. During my presidency, I want you to answer this question. What can you do for UUCFM? I'm asking each of you to commit to volunteering on at least, more than one is fine, but at least one committee, one team, one task force, a social group, a social justice activity, or a congregational activity. Wouldn't it be wonderful if we were known as the congregation that was there? If there is a march for justice, we roll and walk together. If there is another natural disaster, we are there helping people. I would love to see us live our values in action. Just like in the skit, we need to find a few somebodies to join us in our mission. Maybe you want to lift up your voice and join the UUCFM choir. Our music director is one of the nicest people I have ever met. Because I know in past congregations, people have been intimidated by the music director. But I'm telling you, John is the nicest person in the whole wide world. Wouldn't it be amazing to see the choir move from 6 people to 20 or 30 people? Yeah! That's what I'm envisioning. So please ask John or a member of the choir after the service if you've been thinking about joining the choir. They are looking for a few good voices. And in your order of worship, you will find that they meet regularly, March 6th, and every Wednesday at 5:30 p.m. in Classroom 7, 5:30 p.m. for instruments, 6 p.m. for singers. All are welcome. And you have John's email address. So if you're not ready to say something to today, you need to think about it until tomorrow, you can email him. Perhaps you would like to start a dance group here at UUCFM. I will be the first person to join you. Many of you know that I was very active in the Maryland Congregation Chalice Dancers. Just like singing in the choir, the Chalice dancers dance during the service. And I don't see Deborah Lee. Is Deborah Lee here? Oh, Deborah Lee, if you are on Zoom, would you like to start dancing again? Please see me after the service if you want to join the Board of Trustees this upcoming church year. We do have an opening for president-elect. You could be me. The worship associate always seek new people to bring their ideas to the pulpit. In every person lies a great sermon to be preached. Please see me or another worship associate after the service. Our incredible tech team is looking for volunteers. If you are techie, please join their team. Please go to the tech booth after the service or email techteam@uucfm.org and find out how you can help them. If you are interested in growing our members, join the membership team. See Marge Gonzalez after the service. We are also looking for members to join the futures team, the endowment team, the finance team, the operations team, the social justice team, and the life team, and whatever other teams I am missing. Please look for people after the service if you are interested. While the road may be rutty, muddy, and rough ahead, we need to be a beacon of light in our community. I want UUC to be here years and years and years after my presidency ends. We need everyone to take that first step, that first move, or that first role to become involved in UUCFM. Blessed be. Amen. Let it be so. So please join us in hymn number 1028, Fire of Commitment. Please rise in body and spirit to sing number 1028, The Fire of Commitment. The words are on your screen above, and the music is in the teal hymnal. Congregation, and we donate all of our undesignated funds collected during the offering to a different charity every month. During the month of March, our community sharing recipient is the Southwest Florida Voices. The Southwest Florida and Gay Lesbian Chorus was formed in 1993 at the initiative of Doug Gathers and a small group of founders, despite the problems that would undeniably come with his coming out publicly. Since their founding in 1993, they have been a LGBTQ-friendly and all-inclusive 503 nonprofit organization. This group participates in local, regional, and national performances. If you want to donate to our congregation, you can write an old-fashioned check and put UUCF in the memo line, or use one of the envelopes and check UUCFM. For our Zoom users, you may log into UUCFM.org and press the orange button to donate virtually. Please designate if you are donating to UUCFM or Southwest Florida Voices, or provide the percentage of your donation. The offering will now be generously given and gratefully received.
Start with one small voice.
Spirit as we seek to state the words of gratitude. By the work of our hands, please join me in our words as we extinguish our chalice. To extinguish this flame, but not the light of truth, the warmth of community, or the fire of commitment. These we carry in our hearts until we are together again. And please be seated. As we conclude our time together, let us carry forward the light of shared vision and the warmth of community. May the dreams we have explored today be seeds planted in the fertile soil of our hearts, ready to grow and flourish. As we step out or roll out into the world, may we be beacons of hope, agents of justice, and builders of a future where love and understanding reign. Blessed be, Ashe, and Amen, and Amen. My farewell words, thank you for being with us today. Please join us in Hobart Hall after the service. It's right out those doors and make a right. And for join us for coffee and conversation. And please feel free to exit the service during the postlude.